crew, Rocco here. So today we're doing FTD Facts. Oh man, I'm keen as hell for this one. 10 amazing Indian discoveries and or inventions. Are you ready, guys? It's going to be good, man. Be sure to check out FTD. They just opened up FTD South Asia as well. New channel dedicated completely to all that stuff. So let's have a look. You guys ready? You ready for this? I'm trying to say we're fucking doing it. Are you ready? Let's go. My message, especially to young people, is to have courage to think differently, courage to invent, to travel, to explore path, courage to discover the impossible and to conquer the problems and succeed. Yeah, hell yeah. 11th president. Whoa! Is that legit real? Holy.
In this episode of FTD Facts, we take a look at one of our favorite countries to explore and the country that has our largest viewership right now, India. You'll be surprised to know that India and the Indian inventions and discoveries were extremely important in shaping the modern world that we have today. Thanks for joining me here on another episode. My name is Leroy Kenton, and now this video was requested by one of you guys, actually. Vikas Bishnoi sent us an email and said, hey, you guys should do a video on Indian inventions and discoveries. So we're like, okay, cool. And what he also did was sent us in facts to help contribute to this episode. So thanks, Vikas.
You
are our official co-producer of this episode. Vikas. But before we start off with the inventions and discoveries, I want to know, guys, what do you love most about Indian culture? Let me know down there. I love the food. Oh my goodness. I could use some samosas and some gulab jamun right now. So the first...
I think we'll stop that right there, guys. I think what I like about the Indian culture the best... wouldn't be the movies, but they're a close second. I think what I like about the Indian culture is the color. And not the color of people. Just the color that is in India is amazing to me. I find it like... It's like a rainbow of a country. Anyway, shut up, Rocco. Let's do it.
First of 10 discoveries and inventions that I'm going to be highlighting in this episode is gravity. An Indian mathematician by the name of Aryabhatta first discovered the force to explain why objects don't fall when the Earth rotates. Another Indian mathematician, Brahmagupta, he described gravity as an attractive force and used the term Gurutvakarshan for gravity. Aryabhatta developed a geocentric solar system of gravitation and an eccentric elliptical model of the planets, where the planets spin on their axes and follow the elliptical orbits, the sun and the moon revolving around the Earth in epicycles. Next up, number two is this. Not the letter O, but the number zero. Now, one thing to note that the digit zero has always been linked to ancient philosophy of nothingness and is one of the many examples of intermeshing of science and math.
I'm going to stop you right there, Leroy. I already know this fact because my crew, my subscribers, never, no matter what Indian video it is, they never let me forget the fact that they invented the zero. It's like my number one, that and the Golden Temple is free and made of real gold. Let's do it!
With combining it with spirituality and philosophy in ancient India. Indians, however, were the first to use zero as a symbol and also in arithmetic operations, although Babylonians used zero to signify the absent. In those early times, a blank space was used to denote zero. Later, when it created confusion, a dot was used to denote zero. Around the time of 500 AD, when Aryabhatta was alive, he then gave the new symbol for zero, which we now know as this. Moving on to binary numbers. Binary numbers were first described by Pingala around 200 BC.
Wait a minute. Binary? Oh my god, India invented the Matrix.
He is the one.
That's hardcore, guys.
Is a traditional name of the author of the Chandasatra, which is the earliest known Sanskrit treatise on prosody. And prosody is a pattern of rhythm and sound used in poetry. Now, for all the people who just love math in school, the decimal system as well as the quadratic system was also created by Indians. It was in the 7th century CE when Brahmagupta found the first general formula for solving quadratic equations. The decimal system, or the Hindu number system, which was a precursor for the Arabic numeric system, was developed in India between the 1st and the 6th century CE. Next up, we have carburized steel. Ancient Indians had mastered the production of high-quality steel more than 2,000 years before the process finally became simplified in Britain and Europe. The legendary Indian Woot steel was a source of great wonder to other great civilizations from ancient Greece to Persia, as well as from Arabia to ancient Rome. It was so advanced and so much value was put on it that it was selected by King Porus as a gift over what Alexander the Great offered him, which was gold and silver. Now let's talk about water on the moon. One of the independent India's most notable contributions to modern space exploration happened between 2008 and 2009, with Chandrayaan 1, the Indian Space Research Organization's first dedicated lunar mission. The ISRO's Polar Satellite Launch Vehicle.
There's no fucking way that photo was real. Then let's move on.
Carried both ISRO and NASA instruments, of which the Indian Moon Impact Probe first detected the presence of water on the moon. Now, there's always jokes about this next invention, flushed toilets.
I think when they mean presence of water on the moon, they mean ancient traces that water was once on the moon. I'm not sure, I could be wrong, I'm not a fact channel. Let's keep it rolling.
People tease India all the time because of the accessibility issues that they have with toilets. However, flush toilets were first used in the Indus Valley civilization. These existed in most homes and were connected to a sophisticated sewage system. The civilization was very prominent in hydraulic engineering. Now, a lot of what we see printed in this world is due to the invention of ink. Many ancient cultures and civilizations independently discovered and prepared ink for writing purposes. Now, the source of the carbon pigment used in ancient Indian ink called musi was Indian. Way back since the 4th century BC, the practice of writing with ink with a sharp pointed needle was common in South India. Now, all you ladies, I'm telling you, probably would die without this next invention, shampoo. Gotta make that hair shiny and clean. The word shampoo derives from champo. It was initially used as a head massage oil for the Nawabs of Bengal during the Mughal Empire around 1762. It then evolved into shampoo over the years. Now, in every bathroom in every home around the world, we see shampoo. Now let's talk about these little things.
Stop it right there. Sergeant Rocco doesn't use shampoo. For obvious reasons. Let's move on.
It's not the mic, but the button. I don't know if you can see it right here. Buttons were first used in Mohenjo-Daro for ornamental purposes rather than for fastening pieces of clothing together.
That'd be a badge then.
Back when they were first used, as I mentioned in Mohenjo-Daro, it was an Indus Valley civilization around 2000 BC. So those were just 10 of the amazing Indian discoveries and inventions that have impacted our world today. Definitely, by no means are those the only ones. If you guys really enjoyed this video, let me know down below. Give it a thumbs up as well. And if you want a part two, leave it down below.
Yeah!
India has long since been a major contributor with these discoveries and inventions that we took a look at that again helped shape the global society as we know it today. To the nation of India, we can all share in sharing these two words. Thank you.
Thank you. Thanks, Leroy. Right, guys, I've liked it, left a comment. I suggest you do the same. That was awesome. I love stuff like this. Absolutely cool. Taj Mahal facts. Leave a like if you want to see Taj Mahal facts as well by FTD, reacted by Sergeant Rocco. That was cool, man. There's some really, really cool ones in there. Like, definitely, it's amazing to me that a lot of it's maths and numbers, for starters. But, oh, my God. Yeah, you've got binary, and then it was the multiplications, and it was a zero. Man, it's hardcore. The toilet, of course. Yep, that's a big one. We need that. That was 10 amazing Indian discoveries and or inventions. I like that, man. That was cool. Let me know down below if there's any that Leroy missed out that I need to know about. I'm pretty sure that was a good 10. I like that. I'm hoping they're doing a part two. We'll definitely be doing that, guys. Anyway, I'm me and you're you. Hit the like, subscribe. I don't know if you, it's not really worth sharing, but share if you want to. It fucking helps. It helps me out, man. It helps me out huge. And while we're here on the helping fact, how about dropping down to the Patreon page? Check out the rewards. If there's any that you like, hit it up. We'll get talking. We'll get chatting. Get yourself a private Sergeant Rocco video. Whether it's, well, it could be anything. The possibilities are endless. Anyway, guys. that's it. I'm going to go off and, God, I really feel like I haven't done anything with my life. I haven't invented anything. No. My Sergeant Rocco YouTube channel, that's it. That's all I've invented. Damn. I don't think I'll be getting my FTD Facts video anytime soon. See you in the next one, eh?